हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ पैथोलॉजी व्हिच वी आर डूइंग फ्रॉम मीडियम रॉबिन्स। आज की वीडियो का टॉपिक है ए प्लास्टिक एनीमिया। अच्छा, ए प्लास्टिक एनीमिया बेसिकली इज अ डिसऑर्डर इन व्हिच मल्टीपोटेंट माइलोइड स्टेम सेल्स आर सप्रेस्ड लीडिंग टू बोन मेरो फेलियर। सो वेन एवर वी यूज दिस वर्ड ए प्लास्टिक, इट बेसिकली मीन्स दैट द होल बोन मेरो हैज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम। सो द बोन मेरो इटसेल्फ इज नॉट वर्किंग और जो हमारे हेमाटोपोएटिक स्टेम सेल्स हैं दे आर डिस्टर्ब्ड। एंड व्हेन दिस विल हैपन व्हेन देयर इज बोन मैरो फेलियर, नाउ इमेजिन व्हाट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम द बोन मैरो। बोन मैरो गिव राइज टू रेड ब्लड सेल, द बोन मैरो गिव राइज टू व्हाइट ब्लड कॉर्पसल्स, इट गिव राइज टू प्लेटलेट्स। ऑल दीज सेल टाइप्स विल बी रिड्यूस्ड इन नंबर एंड दिस इज व्हाट वी कॉल पेनसाइटोपेनिया। तो सबसे पहले आपको ये सारी टर्म्स पता होनी चाहिए कि पेनसाइटोपेनिया is because of bone marrow failure, because the hematopoietic stem cells are suppressed and this condition is known as aplastic anemia. There will not only be anemia but will also be lack of WBCs as well as lack of platelets. Okay, it must be distinguished from pure red cell aplasia in which only the erythroid progenitors are disturbed. So aplastic anemia mein sare precursors are disturbed. Your WBC count will be low, your red blood cell count will be low, also your platelet count will be low. Then there is a designated condition which is known as pure red cell aplasia. Isme, as the name indicate, only the red cell precursors are disturbed. Okay, so aapko ye terminologies is first paragraph mein bilkul clear honi chahiye. And then let's talk about the pathogenesis. The pathogenesis of aplastic anemia is not fully understood, but two major etiologies have been identified. Number one, extrinsic immune mediated suppression of bone marrow progenitors. Yani there will be something ki hamari jo bone marrows hain usme koi autoimmune type of reaction hokar there will be suppression of the bone marrow. And then there is an intrinsic issue jisme there the problem lies within the stem cells. So if the stem cells jinko usually divide hona tha into erythroid precursor myeloid precursors, they are disturbed, so there can be intrinsic problem within the stem cells. There can be extrinsic issue which is more associated with autoantibodies which destroy the stem cells. Okay, experimental studies have focused on a model in which activated T cell response suppress hematopoietic stem cells. It is hypothesized that stem cells are first antigenically altered by exposure to the drugs, infectious agents, or unidentified. So autoimmunity ऐसे काम करती है कि हमारी बॉडी में देर आर इम्यून सेल्स, यू नो वी हैव टी सेल्स एंड बी सेल्स, दे यूजुअली डू नॉट आइडेंटिफाई द सेल्फ एंटीजेंस। जो हमारे सेल्स हैं उनको ये आइडेंटिफाई करके उन पर अटैक नहीं करते बेसिकली। बट इफ यू हैव टेकन सर्टन ड्रग्स और देयर हैज बीन सर्टन इन्फेक्शन और उस ड्रग्स और इन्फेक्शन की वजह से फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी नाउ हैव ऑल्टर्ड एंटीजेनिक प्रोफाइल, सो दीज स्टेम सेल्स नाउ हैव डिफरेंट सॉर्ट ऑफ एंटीजेंस एंड दीज एंटीजेंस आर देन अटैक्ड बाय द टी सेल्स। सो initially there is an exposure to drug or infection and this then results in the activation of the T cell, and as a result of this antigenic alteration there is an immune cell response which is accelerated, and this is why there is destruction of the hematopoietic stem cells. Okay, and the cell response can be mediated by T cells such as T helper type 1 category. They produce a lot of cytokines, for example interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor. They actually kill the hematopoietic stem cells. This scenario is supported by experience with immunosuppressive therapy directed against T cells. So ab is pure mein issue kya hai ki T cells are attacking the hematopoietic stem cells. Now if you use immunotherapy and try to block the T cells which are overactive, to in T cells ko block karne se the disease progresses well. Okay, तो ये एक थ्योरी है। ऑल्टरनेटिवली द नोशन दैट एप्लास्टिक एनीमिया रिजल्ट्स फ्रॉम द इंट्रिंसिक स्टेम सेल एबनॉर्मलिटी सपोर्टेड बाय द ऑब्जर्वेशन शोइंग दैट फ्रॉम 5-10% ऑफ द पेशेंट्स हैव इनहेरिटेड डिफेक्ट्स इन टीलोमरेज व्हिच एज मेंशन्ड अर्लियर इज नीडेड फॉर मेंटेनेंस एंड स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम। सो इफ टीलोमरेज में कोई इशू है देन द सेल्स डाई अर्ली। इट इज हाइपोथेसाइज्ड दैट द डिफेक्ट इन द टीलोमरेज लीड्स टू प्रीमैच्योर सेनेसेंस ऑफ द हेमाटोपोएटिक स्टेम सेल्स, मतलब ये जल्दी बुजुर्ग हो जाते हैं एंड देन दे डाई। die. And because the hematopoietic stem cells die, because of intrinsic telomerase issue, again, we cannot produce the blood cells. So there are two major theories as far as the pathogenesis of aplastic anemia is concerned. Aplastic anemia mein bone marrow bilkul shut off ho gaya, bilkul kaam nahin kar raha. Do reasons hain. One could be RO antibodies and number two could be intrinsic issue, which is largely associated with telomerase malfunctioning in the stem cells. How do patients present clinically? Now imagine, these are the patients who have low red blood cell, they have low platelets and they have low WBCs. So because of low red blood cells, they will present with the signs and symptoms associated with anemia. With the low platelet count, they will have bleeding tendency. With low WBC count, they will be prone to infection. Okay, so aplastic anemia affects person of all ages and both genders. The slowly progressive anemia causes development of weakness, pallor and dyspnea. So signs and symptoms associated with anemia. There can be thrombocytopenia, which means low platelets, and these patients therefore can manifest with petechiae and ecchymosis, bleeding tendency. And neutropenia, which means low WBCs, they set the stage for serious infections. It is important to separate aplastic anemia from anemia which is caused by marrow infiltration, such as, which is known as, heading mein topic mein dekhenge, myelopathic anemia and granulomatous disease, which may have similar clinical presentation but are easily distinguished by examination of the bone marrow. So there is a condition jisme bone marrow mein there are infiltration of exogenous cells, and in such condition also the bone marrow is not working properly, and these patients will also have low blood count, low all the blood cells, basically WBCs, red blood cells and platelets. But how would you identify ki jo profile, clinical profile patient ki hai, is it because of aplastic anemia or myelopathic anemia jisme infiltration hoti hai? Simply do a bone marrow tap. Agar isme aapko normal cells mil rahe hain, normal stem cells mil rahe hain, normal blast cells mil rahe hain, so basically the bone marrow is working fine. तो probably there are chances कि किसी चीज़ की infiltration हुई है and that can be treated separately. However, if you don't see any blast cells, if you don't see any normal precursors, तो इसका मतलब bone marrow ही काम नहीं कर रहा, bone marrow ही फारिग हो गया है. So that is a different etiology then. So अगर बिल्कुल bone marrow cells activated नहीं है, so that is aplastic anemia. Okay? Now the prognosis is unpredictable. Some patients actually behave very well to therapy, some patients do not respond. Withdrawal of an inciting drug sometimes lead to remission. मैंने आपको यहाँ pathogenesis में start में बताया था कि one of the mechanism is the autoimmune attack on the stem cells, और ये autoimmune attack is incited by certain drugs or infection. So if you take away those drugs, sometimes patient behave very well. Hematopoietic stem cell transplantation is often curative, so that has been considered, but it comes with side effects, particularly in non-transfused patients younger than 40 years. So this is one of the option. Pure ka pura bone marrow kahin se transplant kar dein taki it starts working again. Transfusion sensitizes patients to alloantigens, producing a high rate of engraftment failure. So this is a general feature and a general issue associated with transplantation. Chahe aap kidney transplantation ki baat karein ya bone marrow transplantation ki baat karein, there are obviously side effects associated with this, one of which is very common host versus graft reaction. Successful transplantation requires conditioning with immunosuppressive radiation and chemotherapy. This is also a general principle for transplantation. So whenever you're doing transplantations, for example, aap kisi mein kidney ka transplant karte hain, so you're obviously introducing a foreign body into somebody's body. To jo T cells or B cells hain is patient ke, jiske andar transplant kiya hai, they are going to attack this kidney. So what you need to do is, jab aap transplant karte hain, then you need to suppress these T and B cells. Inko aap shut down karte hain. This is what we call immunosuppressive therapy. This is why whenever we do transplant, we usually tend to give immunosuppressive therapy, taki T cell or B cell silent ho, taki jo graft humne kiya hai wo settle ho sake body ke andar. Okay, same we do in the bone marrow case. So if there is a transplant of bone marrow, so bone marrow is transplanted in this patient, this is a foreign body, the T cell and the B cell will attack the bone marrow, which is a foreign body, kyunki aapne transplant kiya. In order to prevent the attack from T and B cells, what you have to do then is you have to suppress these T and B cells, and this is what we call immunosuppressive therapy. And as mentioned earlier, patients who are poor transplantation candidates often benefit from immunosuppressive therapy. So simply give immunosuppression taki jo auto antibody production hai wo khatam ho jaye. Okay, so Then, very quickly, myeloptic anemia. This is caused by extensive infiltration of the marrow by the tumors or other lesion. इस कंडीशन में भी बोन मैरो विल अल्टीमेटली नॉट वर्क, लेकिन यहाँ कॉज डिफरेंट है. देखें, यहाँ ऑटो एंटीबॉडी डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बोन मैरो नहीं है, यहाँ हिमेटोपोरिक स्टेम सेल्स में कोई गड़बड़ नहीं है, बल्कि कहीं कैंसर है एंड द कैंसर सेल्स आर इन्फिल्ट्रेटिंग इन द बोन मैरो. सो दैट्स द पैथोलॉजी. और इस इन्फिल्ट्रेशन की वजह से भी बोन मैरो विल नॉट वर्क. इन मोस्ट इट मोस्ट कॉमनली इज एसोसिएटेड विद मेटास्टेटिक ब्रेस्ट कैंसर, लंग कैंसर, प्रोस्टेट कैंसर. सो दोज कैंसर सेल्स गेट इन टू द बोन मैरो. Other tumors also advanced tuberculosis, lipid storage disease, even osteosclerosis. The principal manifestation include anemia because bone marrow is disturbed. So red blood cell nahi bante, platelets kaam nahi karte, and white cells are less affected but they can also be affected. So basically iska jo clinical profile hai, it is very much similar to aplastic anemia. Maine aapko differentiate karne ke liye bataya what you will do a bone marrow tap. If you find some normal cells, it is myeloptic anemia. If you don't find anything normal, this is probably aplastic anemia. Okay, characteristically misshapen red cell, some resembling teardrops are seen in the peripheral blood, but you still see good quantity of red blood cell as well as the precursors in the bone marrow. Immature granulocytic erythrocytic precursors may also be present, along with mild leukocytosis. Treatment is directed at the underlying condition. Obviously, the problem is not primarily within the bone marrow, the problem is somewhere else. There is a breast cancer. So you treat the breast cancer and this improves. Okay, so that's all about the anemia discussion that I had to do with you. In the next video, I will then start another topic, which primarily is increased red cell count and then the white blood cell disorder. So take care, stay tuned. My name is Professor Asif Qureshi and you are watching Dr. Asif Lectures.